My name is David Faure and I work for KDAB. In this video, I want to show you how to style widgets using Stylesheets. Qt offers us the possibility to write a stylesheet, a little bit like the CSS stylesheets on the web, but with a specific subset and adaptations for Qt. So it's called QSS, Qt stylesheet. We can set a stylesheet on a widget, or we can set it for the whole application and use selectors for the type of widgets. And that second solution is faster, it's more performant, because if you set a stylesheet for every widget and you create 50 widgets, the stylesheet will have to be parsed 50 times. So in general, prefer to have a global application stylesheet. In that stylesheet, what we are going to do here is to style progress bars. Again, just like in the previous video, the goal is to go from this unstyled or Windows style progress bar to a progress bar that is styled using a stylesheet to make the corners round and to have a gradient and these kind of things, and to have the text inside of the progress bar. So to do that, we are going to write in our stylesheet, this is for every Qt progress bar. We want to set a border color, border width and style, a background color, the height of the progress bar, the radius for the border here, and where to align the text. Now, if we go into this with more details, what we can see is the first problem is hard coding colors here. We want different colors whether we are in dark mode or light mode. We could, of course, fork the whole text of the stylesheet and have two versions of it, but then we would be repeating things like height, which are unrelated to colors, so we don't want to do that. So instead, what I did in this example here is to do a little bit of pre-processing of the stylesheet. Qt doesn't offer anything like that to us, but what we can do is add markers like the dark and light in the comments. And then in the code that loads this stylesheet, I'll do, that's in main dialog. I'll do, depending on the dark mode, let's filter out the lines that contain light in dark mode or dark in light mode. So we simply remove the lines that we don't want, and that's what we are going to give to Qt application set stylesheet. It's quite common to have to do these kind of things. Another common use case is to have placeholders for colors and other things in the stylesheet. This is also not provided by Qt, but what some people do is to use a library called Qt Advanced Stylesheets, where if we look at one of their examples, they have these kind of things with secondary dark color in double curly braces, and that gets replaced by the actual value at runtime when loading this file. So this is just additional stuff on top to be able to have variables in stylesheets. Okay, so that's how we do for the colors. But of course, we still have to duplicate this from Qt push button, which has the same kind of definitions up there, because we can't really share those because I didn't do the thing with variables, only the dark and light mode selector. So that's already a difference with the previous video where we could have a nice color repository and have the colors in a single place. Next problem is the text. We want the text on the right side. We can do that with text align. And if you compare the two, actually, you can see that in here it's nicely slightly on the left of the right edge. And with the stylesheet, it actually collides with the right edge because we have no way to ask for a little bit of spacing here on the right of the text. We would want something like, you know, I want 6 pixels padding on the right, but there is no support for that, so we can't actually do that. The other thing you can maybe see on the video is that the gradient, which looks quite nice here, looks somewhat buggy here. The direction of the gradient is wrong, and especially the outline has a wrong gradient. There is a bit of purple here and a bit of blue here. Something goes wrong with the painting of that gradient. And I actually looked into it and I submitted a bug report for the gradient, also for the buttons. It's different. This one is a nice diagonal gradient and this one becomes vertical for some reason. This uses a mode in QGradient. It's called object mode, and that mode seems, I don't know, buggy somehow. So we get wrong results with stylesheets, whereas when we use the default mode with QPainter here, we get a nice rendering. The other thing, I don't know if that's going to be visible, there is something interesting here where the designer asked for the current value to be shown not just in the in this rectangle here, but also on the groove itself. There is a bit of light blue here on the left, and it becomes gray here, right? So the groove itself shows the current value depending on where it is. We have no way to do that with a style sheet. At least I can't think of any way to do that. It's just not provided. Another funny thing is what happens if we go to a very small value, like 1%. This looks okay, right? It's not perfect, but it's acceptable. If we do the same here with a style sheet, what? We get a square here. We wanted a rounded rectangle and we get a square. Even though we did specify a radius for the, we have 11 pixels border radius. I looked into the code and what happens is this is just ignored if the rectangle is not big enough. If it's less than 11 pixels, it will fall back to drawing a normal rectangle. So this looks very strange. When we get past some value here at 8%, suddenly it becomes round. This is another thing where when using style sheets, you're constrained by the way the implementation is done, whereas when you use a widget style, you can just do your own implementation. Interesting note about that, style sheets are actually implemented as widget style. So anything you can do with style sheets, you can do with widget styles, but that's not true the other way around because, well, the implementation of the style sheet style does things in a certain way, and all we are doing is giving parameters to that. But if we want to go outside the box, we can't do that. Another thing that I haven't implemented here, but the designer would also like some animations, like when we go over the start button, the hover effect should come in gradually. That is possible in a widget style. We need a timer and we need to update the widget and repaint it a couple of times. With style sheets, we can't really do that. Well, we would have to change the style sheet itself at every iteration of the animation. That sounds costly, not very convenient. I guess it is possible, but it's just not very convenient. So to conclude, you can use style sheets for doing simple things. If you want to change the background color of a button, yes, you can use a style sheet for that. It's easy. It's certainly a lot easier, right? There is a lot less code to write for simple things, but you should be ready to hit issues with the limitations of style sheets and the things that it just can't do. If you can sort of discuss with your designer and find compromise and say, okay, I want to negotiate, can we change that and do it differently, then maybe you can stick with style sheets. But if you have to implement a given strict style guide and you cannot deviate from it, then widget styles will give you a lot more flexibility. So I hope you enjoyed this comparison between style sheets and widget styles and how to write them. In the next video, I will show you how to write custom widgets as we do here with those toggle switch widgets. Thank you. See you soon.